Hey crafters, it's Janet with Crafting It Up and Creations. So coming at you today with another ornament in my 2019 Make It Merry ornament series. So this is Saturday and I have some special news. Starting tomorrow, I will have a week-long videos every day of a new ornament that you can do yourself, for your own tree, for craft shows, and hopefully I'll inspire you to make some type of ornament this year, even if it's not every single ornament that I've made. So last week's ornament featured ladders, and I used these craft sticks from Hobby Lobby. They're $3.99 regular price. This week, all Christmas stuff is on sale, 50% off. So that is an awesome deal. You can get them for $2, or you can get them out of your backyard. This is a moss mixture. You can get this at Walmart, Joann's, Michaels, any craft store will carry it, but it's got all kinds of different type of mixes in it. You can use Spanish moss. This comes from the Dollar Tree. It works really well. You can get it anywhere, but it's only a dollar at the Dollar Tree. As well as reindeer moss. It's a really nice, pretty green color. A lot of times this is really soft, really pliable. And then I also will be using this moss. It's a brownish, dark brown, light brown collection that I got from Joann's on clearance. And I really tried to use like the muted tones on this. And then I went outside and gathered a bunch of sticks in my backyard. No lie, I'm gonna add them to the Hobby Lobby ones. I admit the ones from Hobby Lobby are thicker and more sturdier, so I did use them as the base. But I love these because they have like the, you know, like actual little moss stuff on them. I'm going to use my SureBonder heat gun and a bunch of glue sticks. Actually, I only use two glue sticks for this. Nothing like the faux fur stuff. And then I'm going to just kind of put it out there on my grid mat and try to measure out the size of the window as best as I can with that. And I did start out with two sticks that were the same length. And then I'm going to kind of just build around it. The two smaller ones in the middle were from the outside because I wanted something that was really thin for the window panes. And then the four on the perimeter starting out are from Hobby Lobby. Now, if I were to do this all over again, and I probably will make more of these because I absolutely love how it turned out, I would put the Hobby Lobby ones on both sides of this window pane and then build it up around it. Even if I didn't add any more to the back, but I would have put one on the top, one on the bottom. And that probably would even make it just slightly more secure. But I try to measure them out and find sticks that are the same size. As you can see, it works for the most part, but I end up with a little gap here and there. Sometimes I'll have hot glue in areas that the stick didn't touch, and it's all okay because in the end, we're going to cover a lot of those areas with the moss. And the glue doesn't hold all that well. But once you keep building up on it, it does perfectly fine. You could also reinforce it with some other glues, of course, but I think this is gonna hold really well, especially once you build up on it. And I just take sticks from the outside, I kind of break them and add them to the surrounding perimeter of the little window. I want some along the top and the bottom that are just a little bit longer than the ones on the side. I think that just gives it so much more character. I take my heat gun at the very end and kind of blow across it to get rid of some of the little extra webs from all that hot glue that I've put on the, you know, the window seals itself. And that does help make them disappear. You could also use a hairdryer if you just have a hairdryer on hand. But this is what it looks like kind of bare naked. Like I say, you can kind of see some of that glue hanging out in the sides. But we're going to pull out this moss and use it. I really like in the moss mixture the ones that kind of look like, almost like if you were walking through the forest, those little pieces of branches that hang down. And I'm just going to throw a bunch of the moss out on the table and then strategically hot glue it in whatever area that I think it looks good in. Or to even just to hide the glue. I think that the Spanish moss is an awesome idea to maybe even make a bird's nest. So I may build on that idea with another video. But I did try to make a little one in the corner, as you'll see here in a little while. But I don't have anything small enough to go there for like a little bird or a bird's egg. But if I find one, I might add it to it. And otherwise, there is no rhyme or reason to how I added this to the window seal or to the window itself. There were certain places where I thought that maybe I should build it up, so I ended up adding a few more sticks to it. And I just tried to, in the end, I tried to put the glue where I knew the stick would land. And I tear off the little pieces and kind of just shove them in there. I do try to even push them into those areas so it looks like it's growing out from the sticks. And I thought that looked really good. And anywhere I thought that placement looked good on it. You'll have to let me know what you think. This one just kind of came to me today, and I was getting ready to put some of my supplies away, and I was like, let me use some more of these sticks. You could definitely still use some of them, or all of them, from the little packs that come from Hobby Lobby. I just thought that it gave it just a little bit more of a rustic feel by using some of them that were from outside. One of the things that I love, love, love doing is making ornaments. It's one of the things that I have done just about every year for the kids and for family members and different things. I always put them in Christmas craft shows and different things. And I've made so many over the years, and I thought, well, let's do a special. So that's kind of where all this ties in. Like I say, next week will be a week-long special where I'll have different ornaments every day. I'm going to go back and use some of the supplies that I've already used in some other videos. So if you do buy some of those supplies, maybe I'll give you other ideas or other inspiration for you to use, or to use up your supplies. If you're like me, that's what we all need to do. So I did place a lot of these in a whole lot of different areas, and I really love how this turned out. I decided that the green was just a little bit too much, so I decided to keep it really neutral. I even thought about dry brushing some white paint across it, because someone had mentioned that in the previous ladder video, and I thought that would be a really great idea, but it just didn't lead to the look for this, so I left it alone. I may try that in a future one. If I do make more of these, I may not do another video. I might do like a project share, or I'll share them over on my Facebook page. And my Facebook page is Crafting It Up in Creations too, if you want to go over there and visit. I'd love to get some people to upload some of their pictures to that page. I would love to have more interaction with all you crafty people out there. Now, this little pick is actually a different one, but it's the Blooming Holiday. It's from Joann's. I lost this footage, but this is like these little pink frost pip berries are the same exact company. And I used those, and I glued on this little piece of glittered branch. And I believe this one is from Michael's. I cut a piece off of it, glued it up to the corner, added the pip berries, and added that really pretty bow. This is like a velvet feel, and this ribbon is from Joann's this year. This is $4.99 per spool, but they've been having tons of sales lately, so you can definitely get it a lot cheaper than that, but I love that color. Definitely will use that in a future video, or at least future projects here for Christmas. I added that up to the corner and just glued them down with the hot glue. I'm going to add one of my rusty bells up there to the corner as well. I happen to have some of the bigger ones. This isn't the biggest one, but I decided just to go ahead and add one. And I think with the muted colors and that light pink, I just absolutely love it. Now I'm going to use some twine from the Dollar Tree. I'm going to double it over, and I'm actually going to knot it twice because I want an area on that twine where I can put a good dollop of glue and use it to put on the back part of this ornament so it'll stay in place really well. And I'm gonna glue the little knots into the corner underneath, kind of where it hides them. And then I'll measure it out to how much I think that I want it to hang by. And then I decide to knot the other end, two knots, and then I'm gonna glue those in place. And I felt like when I held it up, it kind of leaned forward too much. So I did end up adding some glue along the top, like two or three branches up across the top. And I'll show you here in just a second. Just to kind of make it a little more sturdier. So I put some hot glue there and glued it kind of across on both sides. And that made it hang just a little bit better where it didn't kind of thrust it forward some. So let me know in the comments down below, what do you think of this one? So using the sticks again, a little bit different idea, another kind of rustic farmhouse look, even could lead the way to a fairy tree. I think that would be an awesome idea. I have a really small tree and I would love to just start doing like a little fairy tree. I may do some fairy ornaments. The ideas are endless. So let me know what you think. Come back tomorrow, same time, same channel, and I'll have another video for you for another Christmas ornament. I hope you guys are having a great weekend. I hope you get a moment to craft it up. Thanks so much for stopping by and spending time with me. I really do appreciate it. Take care and God bless.